welcome to What I Wish I Knew, a series where we uncover IoT implementation lessons, advice, and the occasional regret from the innovators leading the way. I'm Jenny Cady, and today we sat down with Stuart Bashford of Bühler, an innovator using IoT to engage their customers in new ways. Stuart talks with us about how IoT has enabled their customers to be more productive, the vital role company culture plays in transformation, and the need to keep things simple without forgetting the people involved in the journey.
So my name is Stuart Bashford. I'm the digital officer for the Bühler Group. What that means for us is it's my job to manage, set the vision and direction for our digital transformation as a company. We've been on the journey now for around about 5 years. At that time, digitalization was big and looming large in our sort of vision. We started to have a look at what was out there and how we could allow or enable our customers to be more productive. And that's when we started to think about IoT and digitalization and what that meant for us, and more importantly, of course, what it means for our customers. Keep it simple. So keep your technological ideas simple, keep the business model simple, and strive for business impact quickly. But it's also about the humans involved, and we ourselves, we've grown to understand and realize that we don't get anywhere with our digital solutions if we don't put equal amount of effort onto managing those human relationships as well. Keep it simple and don't forget the human being. One of the important things with any digital sort of transformation journey is just the recognition that, you know, it is a journey. When we start engaging with our customers, the first conversations could be about a specific use case, but very often after you work on that use case, you deliver the outcomes from that, you find out that there's other things that you can be working on. And then the customer comes to you and says, great, but what if we could do this and what if we could do that? And you know, and that's the great place to get to, because then you're almost co-creating solutions together, and that's where you can, you know, offer the biggest value to our customers at least. This journey is a very iterative process. Be aware that every customer you talk to, or every supplier, every partner, they are also on a journey, and they might be on that journey at a different place than you. That's one thing. And then perhaps another thing is just think about the cultural and structural sort of setup of your organization. Your culture plays a huge part in how you can transform the existing sort of norms and the existing sort of practices within your company to be able to deliver and offer digital services. So, I mean, a very interesting thing on that is very early days in our transformation, our CEO essentially set all of our businesses a very unreasonable challenge. He said, in 9 months' time, I want you to come back and I want you to demonstrate your digital services to me. I don't want to see PowerPoint slides, I want to see digital services. So, you know, in that respect, it was unreasonable. But the very cool thing about it was it mobilized action. And it also meant every single business had to deliver something. 9 months later, we got somewhere around about 8 real customer services, and I think maybe 3 of them have now turned into products that we actually sell. So, you know, a success story there. The very obvious thing there is when we initially engage with our customers, it's usually centered around a few more of the more obvious benefits. You know, we're going to reduce unplanned downtime. That's a key one. Energy usage is getting into the spotlight these days with the sustainability stuff and things. But having connected machines, I mean, you have to look at this within the context. We usually make big machines. They weigh a ton to up to 50 tons. We sell them in one-off transactional business models. But as soon as you make those machines connected and you have the ability to be able to sell a service where we're constantly monitoring the machine to make sure it's operating to its best possible parameters, that then kicks off what we call it a digital relationship with the customer. But what we really mean is we are really strengthening that relationship with the customer. And that just takes you on, I mean, I keep using it, but it takes you on further along that journey of really working together as a partnership to make your business as productive as it can possibly be. what always surprises me is when we engage with customers and we take them on this digital journey, and they suddenly the switch flicks and they suddenly realize, but we could do this and we could do that, and if we could only have that bit of data or that bit of data, we could do this. And I think again that's something that by having this very agile approach of providing a service to our customers and being able to adapt it to what they really need, what that also means is that we can adapt what we're offering to offer them the next thing. But then we have to we talk with the customer and say, well, look, we're monitoring the service and we're curious, you know, we don't quite see the benefits that we think you should be able to get. And after a while it sort of transpires that the customer wasn't always using the service. They don't need some software telling them how to do their job. So they would much rather be assessed on their performance. So they were switching off the service that automatically adjusted some things because they had full confidence in their abilities. And, you know, and so there we had to talk, you know, go back, use the fact that we had these connected products, to use a human being. You know, we're talking about lots of digital technologies, but again, you know, this comes back to a human being having a conversation with the customer, exploring where the problem is, and then talking with the shift operators and saying, look, you know, we still need you guys. You guys still need to be a very important part of this process. But if you just let the machine do the job here in this part, it can optimize that whilst you're doing some more value-added tasks elsewhere. That's one of those sort of stories that I can sort of relate to and you know, could be of use to others. Just recently, one of our customers got every single one of, well, they'd been one of our customers for a while on the digital services, but they'd made the commitment to get every single one of their manufacturing plants connected. And one of the exciting things for me was to sort of see, I got sent a photograph from this particular customer where they had a picture of our Bühler Insights platform in their headquarters. And this meant everyone that comes in through their front door sees effectively our Bühler Insights dashboard, which shows all of their production sites running around North America, actually, in this case, having multiple sites, being able to look at exactly what's going on at a line level, a plant level, a line level, a machine level. And what we'd always said is, if you could put your best operator working on your machines every single second of the day, you would have better production, wouldn't you? I mean, and the answer to that is yes, you would. But you can't do that with human beings. But you can do it with digital services, and this is exactly what we were showing. And they show this dashboard, and it just proved this. So very, very, very pleasing moment. And what's even more pleasing as we go forward in time, even past that, you know, they absolutely love the visibility they get on their process lines. I mean, that's demonstrated the worth of the system. I know we perhaps could have done a few things a little differently. I mean, one of the key things I would say, we had senior buy-in from the very top of our company, from the board of directors, executive board, right from the very beginning. And that is an absolute essential. I hear stories of companies trying to go through a digital transformation without having support at the top, and that must be very hard. Well, we didn't have that situation at Bühler. We were very, very lucky to have full support at that senior level. And then I think another important thing would be just to have a very, very clear understanding of why you're doing this and what you want to achieve, which sounds very sounds simple. If you have a very clear understanding of where and why, it keeps you pointing in the right direction.
Thank you for joining us, and be sure to check out other stories from IoT innovators so that you can take your vision to reality with secure, scalable, and open edge-to-cloud solutions. To learn more about the solutions that Bühler implemented, be sure to check out their case study and other resources linked here, or visit azure.com for additional IoT solutions and services.